Hello everyone, welcome to Matrix YouTube channel. Today we are here to discuss the solutions of Matrix Olympiad paper which was held on 8th of October. So we will start from class 8th and the subject is physics. Let us start our question paper. So we have our first question and that is equal forces F act on isolated bodies A and body B. The mass of B is thrice time of that of A. The magnitude of the acceleration of A. Okay. So let us see here. Let's say we have two objects, object A and object B. Force acting on object A is FA, which is equal to the force acting on object B, which is FB. It is given in question. It is given the mass of B, let's say mass of B is MB, which is three times of mass of A. Let us assume that mass of A is MA. So it is given mass of B is three times of mass of A. So we have to find the acceleration of body A. We know that from this equation number first, force is given by mass into acceleration. So for force acting on A object given by MA into acceleration of A is AA, which is equals to the force on B is given by MB multiplied by AB. MA into A equal to mass of B object can be written as 3 multiplied by MA multiplied by AB. So we'll cancel out MA from this MA and the answer will be acceleration of body A will be 3 multiplied by acceleration of B. So the correct option is 3 times of B. So option A is correct answer. Next question, question number 2. In question number 2, it is said a block of mass 4 kg, that means mass of a block is given, which is 4 kg. Dimensions are given here 10 cm, 20 cm, and 30 cm, length, breadth, and height. Rest on a floor and value of gravitational acceleration is 10 meter per second square. Then the maximum pressure of the block can exert on the floor is. We know that the formula for pressure is given by force upon area. We know that if we want maximum pressure, then area of contact should be minimum, which is only possible when these dimensions are placed on surface. So in this case, I will write P max is equals to force is given by due to gravity, that is 4 multiplied by gravitational acceleration given in question, divided by 10 centimeter into 20 centimeter, but we have to convert into meters. So it becomes 10 multiplied by 20 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4. On solving this, we'll get the answer 2000 Pascal. So correct answer is option A. Next question, question number 3. It is given when a body floats in a water, density is given, then 1/3 of its volume remain outside. Okay. Whereas 3/4 of its volume remain outside when it floats in any liquid. We have to find the density of that liquid in gram per centimeter cube. So we know that the weight is given by upthrust force, or we can say buoyant force. So for case 1, we know that mass of body is mg, which is equal to buoyant force, and in buoyant force the volume which is dipped inside liquid, because outside is 1/3, then the dipped inside liquid part will be 2/3 of its volume multiplied by, let's say, density of water is rho 1 multiplied by g. This is equation number 1. In case 2, we have replaced the water with a liquid and we have to find out the density of that liquid. In that case, mass of object is same and outside part is 3/4, then it means the dipped part will be of, we can say, 1/4 of its volume. Let's say density is rho 2, which we have to find g, equation number 2. By comparing these equations, we can write here 2/3 v rho 1 g, which is equals to 1/4 v rho 2 g. So value of rho 1 is 1, v is cancelled by v, g is cancelled by g. So from here, rho 2 is equals to become 2 multiplied by 4 by 3, which gives the correct answer 8/3. So option B is correct answer. Next question. Next question is question number 4. In this question, it is asked, during the pedaling of a bicycle, force of friction exerted by ground on wheel. So we know that whenever we pedal a bicycle, the friction force on rear wheel act in forward direction and the friction force in front wheel is always in backward direction. So let us check our correct option. It is backward direction on both wheels. It is false. Backward direction on the front wheel and in the forward direction on the rear wheel. That means B is our correct answer. Next question. Next question is question number 5. And we have to check which statement is true and which is false. So let us start with first statement. Weight of a body is always constant. No, it is not necessary. As we know that weight force is given by mass into gravitational acceleration. And we know that at different positions and different heights, depth and different planets, value of G changes. That means value of weight will also change. It is not a constant. So it is a false statement. Second statement, sliding friction is always greater than static friction. This is a false statement because static friction is always greater than sliding friction. Third is, friction force always depends on area of contact. No, friction force does not depend on area of contact. It depends on nature of surface. So it is also a false statement. So let us check which is our correct option. So all three are false statements. So option C will be correct. Next question is question number 6. In this, we have to match the column 1 with column 2. 1 Newton. Newton is a unit of force. We know that in this case, we can write it here. Let us check. For 1 Newton, we can write it is equal to 10 to the power 5 gram centimeter per second square. Bar is unit of pressure, which is equals to 10 to the power 5 Pascal. And 1 line is equals to 1 meter is equals to 10 to the power 5 dyne. So from this, we can check here the correct answer will be, it's 3, 1 and 2. So 3, 1, 2, option B is correct answer. Last question. In last question, a case is given here. And we can say here in this question, it is asked that at point A, B and C, the pressures are respectively PA, PB and PC. So which is a correct answer from these options? We know that at same depth in a liquid, the pressure at all points remains same. So directly we can say the option C is correct answer. So we have completed our solutions for physics subject for class 8. For more information and notification regarding prizes or results of Matrix Olympiad, please subscribe this YouTube channel. Thank you very much.
Hello everyone. Now we will discuss the chemistry portion of class 8. First question is, the polymer used in making non-stick cookware is option number 1, rayon, option number 2, Teflon, option number 3, nylon, and option number 4 is polymers. Option number 1 or A, rayon. Rayon is a fiber. It cannot be used in making non-stick utensils. Nylon is also a fiber. Now let's see the option B. Option B is the right option. Teflon is used in making non-stick cookware. Teflon is a polymer of tetrafluoroethane. So, the right option is option B, Teflon. Now, the next question is, which of the following has the same monomer units? Option A is nylon and cellulose. Option B is polyester and nylon. Option C is rayon and nylon. And option B is cellulose and rayon. Okay, these all are the polymers, and polymers are made up by the monomer units. So the cellulose and rayon both are made by the glucose monomer unit. So the option D is the right option, means cellulose and rayon both have the same monomer unit, and that unit is glucose, or we can say that beta glucose is the exact answer of this question. Okay, now let's see the next question. Next question is, copper sulfate solution can be safely kept in the container made of option 1, aluminium, option B, lead, option C, silver, and option D, zinc. So option C, silver is the right option because aluminium, lead, and zinc, all of the metals are more reactive than copper sulfate. So if we kept copper sulfate in the container of aluminium, lead, or zinc, so these all metals are more reactive than copper, so it displaces the copper from the copper sulfate solution. But the silver is least reactive than copper, so it can't be able to displace the copper from the copper sulfate solution. So the option C is the right option. Now let's see the next question. The next question is, which of the following statement is are true or false? Okay, now let's see the first option. First option is copper cannot displace hydrogen from acids. Yes, this is completely true statement because copper is least reactive than hydrogen, so it cannot displace the hydrogen from acid. So it can easily displace the hydrogen from acids, and we know that in the reactivity series we can see easily that copper is least reactive than, according to that activity series, copper is least reactive than hydrogen, so it cannot display the hydrogen from acid. So the first statement is true statement. Now the second is, iron is found in free state in nature. No, it is not possible because iron is present in the forms of ores or the different substances, and so iron is not found in the free state in nature. So the option second is false statement. Now the next statement is, aluminium oxide is amphoteric in nature. Generally, there are three types of oxide. First is acidic oxide, second is basic oxide, and third is amphoteric oxides. Okay, generally, the acids of non-metals are acidic in nature. Oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature, and the oxides of metals are basic in nature. But we can see that aluminium oxide and zinc oxide, there are the few examples which are amphoteric in nature. Means aluminium, when aluminium oxide react with any acid, so it forms salt, and aluminium oxide when react with any base, then it can also form a salt. Means aluminium oxide behaves as acid as well as base. So the aluminium oxide is amphoteric in nature. Because of its dual behavior, it behaves like amphoteric in nature. So the third statement is a true statement. So the option true, false, and true. Option A is the right option. Now, the next question is, match column first with column second and select the correct answer using the codes given below. First is rain codes, second is thermoplastic, and third is flame resistance. Next, the next option, column second, in the column second, there are three polymers. First is melamine, second polymer is PVC, means polyvinyl chloride, and the third is polystyrene. Okay, now the P is raincoat. We know that the raincoats are formed by PVC, polyvinyl chloride. So the P is matched with the second option. Now the second is thermoplastic. The polystyrene polymer is used for making thermoplastic substances. And now the last is flame resistance. Melamine polymer is used for making flame resistant substances, like the melamine container or melamine containing polymers are used in the electrical switches or the utensils which are used in the microwave also. So we can see that the flame resistant substances are made up by the melamine polymers, and the thermoplastics substances are made by the polystyrene, and the raincoats are prepared or formed by the PVC, polyvinyl chloride. So the option P is connected with third option, P is connected with the second option, and Q is third, and R is matched with the first option. So 2, 3, 1. So option A is the right option. Now let's see the next question. The next question is, Tina sets up apparatus for an experiment as shown in the figure. She performed the same experiment by changing threads P, Q and R. She found that weight required to break the thread is in order X, Y and Z, where X is equals to weight required to break P, Y is equals to weight required to break Q, and Z is equals to weight required to break P. So P, Q and R can be. So in this option, the option A is the right option. Why the option A is the right option? Because in option A, P is nylon, Q is wool and R is cotton. We know that nylon is a synthetic fiber which is much more stronger than wool and cotton. Now we will discuss about the wool and cotton. The tensile strength, or we can say the force of attraction between wool, is more than the cotton. So the option A is the right option for this question. Thank you.
Hello student, welcome to Matrix High School. Today we discuss about Matrix Olympiad paper solution, biology portion for class 8th. Let's start. First question of biology portion. Which of the following is not used as food preservative? Option first, salt. Second, sugar. Third, vinegar. And D, methane. Salt, sugar and vinegar is used as food preservative. But methane is a gas that used as fuel, like gobar gas and biogas. So our right answer is methane. D option is right answer, because according to question, not used as food preservative. Next question. The cutting and gathering of crops after maturation is known as. Option first, harvesting. Option second, threshing, broadcasting and tilling. According to question, crop after maturation, cutting and gathering, that is called harvesting. So our right answer is option A. Next question. The microorganism is responsible for the formation of curd from milk. Option first, fungi. Option second, lactobacillus. C, cyanobacteria and salmonella. Curd formation responsible by lactobacillus, that is LAB, lactic acid bacteria, that convert milk sugar, lactose, into lactic acid. So our right answer is option B. Next, which of the following is rabi crop? Option first, wheat. Option second, maize. Third, paddy. And D, cotton. According to question, rabi crop is wheat. Right answer is wheat. Another option are kharif. So right answer is wheat. Next, bacteriophages are composed of protein that encapsulate a DNA or RNA genome and may have structure that are either simple or elaborate. This portion formed by protein and genetic material enclosed in this capsid. According to question, P option and Q option. P and Q. Option number first, P telpin, Q collar. P tel fiber, Q collar. P collar, Q head. P sheath, Q tel fiber. But in this case, P present at the tail side, that are tail pins, and Q is the collar. So according to question, our right option is P tail pins and Q collar. So right answer is option A. Next one, which of the following statements are true and false? Option first, drip system is a traditional method of irrigation. East is unicellular fungi. Next, the method of loosening the soil is called weeding. According to three statements, our right answer, this one is false. East is unicellular, right. True. The method of the loosening the soil is called weeding, that is wrong. False. So, false, true and false. According to option, false, this one, true, this one is the right answer. Option D is the correct option for the statements. Next question, match the column first and column second and select the correct answer. Rhizobium, AIDS, organic manure, cow dung, virus, nitrogen fixation. Rhizobium related to nitrogen fixation, that fix the nitrogen, atmospheric nitrogen in the soil. Organic manure, that is cow dung, and virus, HIV virus, that related to AIDS, according to options, columns options. So our right answer is P third, Q second and R first. 3-2-1. In this case, 3-2-1, option C is our right answer. These are the biology portion solution for class 8th Matrix Olympiad. Please subscribe to this channel for further notification related to Matrix Olympiad. Thank you.
Hello everyone. I welcome you all in the fourth part of the MOF paper. So before the solution of this fourth part of mathematics, I want to just remind you that ki agar aap channel pe naye hain, to please do not forget to subscribe our channel. Because MOF ki jitni bhi updates hain, wo sari isi channel par aapko milengi. So don't forget to subscribe it. Now, let's get started with the solution of the fourth part. First question hai fourth part ke andar, that is 21st one. Multiplicative inverse of 0 is. Multiplicative inverse 0 ka kya hota hai? To 0 ka multiplicative inverse hota hi nahi hai. So it does not have multiplicative inverse. So here option D is the correct answer. Now let's start the next question, that is 22nd. Product of two numbers is 25, 3 upon 8. Yahan par hume product de rakha hai, do numbers ka, that is 25, 3 upon 8. Let's write it down. One of them is 15, 9 upon 40. To yahan par ek number a gaya, 59 upon 40. Or the other number is, we have to find out the other number. So let the other number be x. So here let it be x. X multiply by 59 upon 40. Isko convert kar dete hain. इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन में दैट इज 609/40 एंड हियर इट विल बी 203/8. Now let's find out the value of x multiplied by 40/609. After the cancellation, we will get 5/3. It means 1/2/3. So the correct answer will be B. That is 1/2/3. Let's move on to the next question, that is question number 23. Now here, it is given that absolute value of 2/3 minus 3/4 is, let's take the LCM. Here the LCM will be 12. 8 minus 9, we will get -1/12 and the answer will be 1/12. So the correct answer will be option C, that is 1/12. Now, let's begin with the next question. Here, 24th question is, if -8+n is equal to 5n/4, then find the value of n. Here, we have to find out the value of n. Let's solve and find out the value of n here. Let's transpose 4 to other side, means left-hand side. We get -32. +4n = 5n. So here the value of n will be 32 = n. So here the value of n is -32. Here option B is the correct answer. Now the next question is 25th question. When 75% of a number is added to 75, then resultant number is the original number. Find the number. We have to find the number. So number find karne ke liye hame kya lena hai? Let's take the number B x. So here the number B x is taken by us. Now here 75% of a number means 75/100x added to 75. The resultant will be the original number. So the original number is our x. So here, let's take the LCM. We get 100 liya, then we have transpose 100 to the another side, that is right hand side. So here the next equation will be 7500 = 100x - 75x. So here we get 7500/25 = x. After cancellation, we will get 300. So the value of x will be 300. So here option B is the correct answer. I hope you understood this. Now the next question is question number 26. Let's solve it. So let's take the LCM of 4 and 5 first. That is equal to 20. Cross multiply it. So here it will be 5y + 30 + 4y - 12. Here it will come 20. So here the answer will be 8. So here the y is 8. Now the option is B here. Now the next question is question number 27. Here we have to find out the angles of the quadrilateral which are given in the ratio. We have to find the smallest angle. So here let the angle be x. So according to the ratios, first is x, then plus 2x plus 3x plus 4x इक्वल टू 360 डिग्री, क्योंकि क्वाड्रिलेटरल का जो सम होता है नॉट इज 360 डिग्री. सो लेट्स कैलकुलेट इट. हियर इट कम्स, 10x इक्वल टू 360 डिग्री. सो वैल्यू ऑफ x इज 36 डिग्री एंड x इज द स्मॉलेस्ट एंगल इन दिस क्वाड्रिलेटरल. सो हियर ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर. Now let's start the 28th question of this paper. 28th question के अंदर आपके पास एक rhombus है and the name of the rhombus is Rice, R-A-C-E. Now here in this question we have to find out the value of x plus y plus z. It's very simple to find out the value. Now how we have to proceed? यहाँ पर हम check करते हैं कि हमारे पास कौन-कौन सी value easily मिल सकती हैं. So in rhombus we know that all the sides are equal और z कहाँ पर है? एक side है. So we can say that one side of rhombus is 13, so rest of the side is also 13. So यहाँ पर z भी क्या आ जाएगा हमारा 13. Now diagonals की बात करें तो diagonals bisect each other at 90 degree. तो diagonals bisect भी करती है और 90 degree का angle भी form कर रही है. It means आपके पास y की value है यहाँ पे 5. Here it's 5, तो y की value भी क्या हो जाएगी 5, क्योंकि ये equal है दोनों. So here, let's get started with the next unknown term. तो यहाँ पर हमें एक unknown side नहीं पता, अगर ये पता चल गई तो x की value भी find out करना easy हो जाएगा. So we are going to apply the Pythagoras theorem. Here Pythagoras theorem is h square plus p square plus base square. Hypotenuse हमारे पास है 13 square. Perpendicular is unknown to us. Base ले लेते हैं हम 5 square, जो कि अभी हमने find out करा है. 13 square is 169 equal to perpendicular square plus 25. So let's calculate it first. So here the value of P is 12. अगर ये 12 है तो value of X भी क्या हो जाएगी आपकी 12. So here we get the values of X plus y plus z, that is equal to x हमारे पास है 12, y is 5 and z is 13. So here let's calculate it first. Here it is sum 30. तो आप बता सकते हो कि ये option A is the correct answer. Now let's start with the question number 29. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 29 PQR इज अ काइट. आपके पास एक काइट दे रखी है जिसमें एंगल आपको P गिवन है, एंगल आपको S गिवन है. अब काइट में आपको क्या फाइंड आउट करना है? यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट एंगल R. सो इट्स वेरी सिंपल टू फाइंड आउट एंगल R. कैसे फाइंड आउट करेंगे? लेट्स स्टार्ट. यहाँ पे सबसे पहले आप एक डायगनल ड्रॉ करेंगे. दिस इज द मेन डायगनल ऑफ द काइट एंड इन काइट जो मेन डायगनल होती है वो क्या करती है? इट बिकम्स अ सिमेट्रिकल. ये क्या करती है? सिमेट्रिकल बनाती है. और जो एंगल होता है अपोजिट एंगल्स होते हैं, जैसे ये ऐसे, तो इसका जो मेन डायगोनल के अपोजिट जो एंगल होता है दैट इज इक्वल. तो ये आपका हो जाएगा 90.5. अब आपके पास तीन एंगल्स हैं. अप्लाई द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल. सो हियर सम ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल इज 360. आपके पास 90.5 प्लस 70 प्लस 90.5 एंड द अननोन angle that is x is given to you and the whole thing is equal to 360 degree. Let's find it out. Here it becomes 251 and so here the value of x is 109. Option D is the correct answer. Now let's start the next question, that is question number 30. A coin is tossed 74 times and head is obtained 32 times. Coin 74 times toss kara gaya aur 32 times head aaya hai usme. Now a coin is tossed randomly. Ab randomly coin ko toss karenge aur hame chahiye tail. To 74 outcomes hamare aaye the jisme se 32 to hamara head. Here after subtraction we get 42 and now what is the probability of this event? Favorable outcome upon total number of outcomes. So after cancellation we will get 21 upon 37. So here option C is the correct answer. Now question number 31. We have a pie diagram, and in this pie diagram it is shown that the students are using different types of modes. Now here the modes are school bus, car and cycle. So here 513 student use car. ये वाला जो पार्ट है ये है 513 students का. The number of student who uses bus are, अब हमें bus का find out करना है कितने number of students हैं. If this is 513, so this will also be 513. आपको क्या करना है, school bus के लिए निकालना है. तो this is a straight line, half में divided है. तो what you will going to do, you will simply multiply 513 by 2 or add 513 and 513, you will get the answer here 1026. That is 1026. And here option B is the correct answer. Now let's start the next question, that is 32. In this question, we have to find out the square root of 0.121. Now let's find out the square root of 0.121. Now first step is हमें बार लगाना है pairs पे, और हमें जो answer चाहिए वो चाहिए 3 place of decimal. Let's find out the answer first. So here after the calculation we get 0.347. So here option C is the correct answer. The next question is 33. In this question we have to find out the cube root of 0.125 plus 3. So here cube root of 125 is 5 upon 10 plus 3. So here 5 plus 30 upon 10 will give us 35 upon 10, which is equal to 3.5. So here option B is the correct answer. So let's begin with the 34th question. In this question, we have to find out which of the following is not a perfect square number. हमें इन चारों number में से ये find out करना है which number is not a perfect square number. So to find out not a perfect square number, we have a property that says that कोई नंबर एंड होता है 2, 3, 7, 8 पे तो वो नंबर हमारा परफेक्ट स्क्वायर नंबर नहीं होगा. तो यहाँ पर हमारे पास जो 4 नंबर्स है, इन आउट ऑफ दीज 4 नंबर्स वी हैव ओनली 1 नंबर विच एंड्स विद 2. सो हियर ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर विच इज नॉट अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर नंबर. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 35. वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द स्मॉलेस्ट square number divisible by each of the number, that is 8, 9, 10. 8, 9, 10 से divide होता हुआ हमें एक number चाहिए जो कि smallest square number हो. So here let's take the LCM. Equal to 360. अब यहाँ पर हम देख सकते हैं कि जो हमारे पास प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन है उसके अंदर पेयरिंग इनकम्प्लीट है 2 and 5 की. सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई टू मेक इट अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर नंबर. 2 multiplied by 5 is 10. नाउ वी विल गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई 360 by 10 टू गेट अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर नंबर. सो हियर इट बिकम्स 3600. सो ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. Now the next question is question number 36. यहाँ पर हमें simplify करना है. We have to find out the cube root of 2197 multiplied by square root of 2025. तो ये हो जाएगा आपका cube root 13 का and 2025 का square root हो जाएगा आपका 45. So after multiplying 13 and 45 we will get 585. So here option A is the correct answer. Now let's start the next question, that is question number 37. In this question, we have to simplify it and then find out the value of square root of x. Let's solve it. यहाँ पे square root है, तो हम सबसे पहले squaring करेंगे दोनों side. So here we left with x multiplied by 0.0000091. After cubing both the side, we get so after solving, we get the value of x, that is 81. And here we have to find out the square root of 81, that is 9. So here option C is the correct answer. Now in the 38th question, if the difference between selling a shirt at profit 10% and 15% is rupees 10, then the cost price of shirt is, we have to find out the cost price. Let the cost price of shirt be x, and let's take the cost price 100. Assume कर लेते हैं 100, तो हमारे पास जो profit हो गया, यानी हमारा SP1 क्या हो जाएगा, 100 plus 10%, that will be 110 upon 100x. So here 1.10 x is SP1, selling price 2 देखते हैं हम, जिसमें profit हुआ हमें 15% का, this is 1.15x. और अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वेश्चन इट इज सेड दैट कि दोनों का जो डिफरेंस है वो कितने का है, 10 का. तो हम लोग इसको सबट्रैक्ट कर लेते हैं, 1.15x माइनस 1.10x दैट इज इक्वल टू 10. सो हियर वी गेट द आंसर 0.05x इक्वल टू 10 एंड x इज 10 अपॉन 0.05. So here the value of x is 200. हमने starting in the cost price shirt की क्या ली थी, x. So here 200 is the cost price of shirt. Option D is the correct answer. Now let's start with the next question, that is 39. If every side of a right angle triangle is double, अगर सारी side right angle triangle की हम लोग double कर दें, then what is the percentage increase in the area of a triangle? So percentage increase हमें बताना है. So let's take the area of a triangle, that is half into base into height. अब x y हमने ले लिया है क्योंकि हमारे पास कोई भी measurement नहीं है. So this is your right angle and here x y and let the hypotenuse be z. तो यहां पर हाफ इंटू बेस इंटू हाइट क्या हो गया हमारा, एरिया ऑफ अ ट्राइंगल. तो ये जो ट्राइंगल है, दिस इज द ओरिजिनल वन. अब क्या कह रहा है, इस ट्राइंगल की जो साइड्स हैं वो क्या कर दी हैं, डबल. तो अब इसी ट्राइंगल में जब डबल कर देंगे तो क्या हो जाएगा, हाफ इंटू, अब एक्स हो गया 2x, वाई हो गया 2y. अब हम यहां से क्या करेंगे, हमारे पास ओरिजिनल ये था, तो अगर ये हमारा एरिया 100% है, सो हेयर 1/2 एक्स वाई मल्टीप्लाई बाय 4. वाई वी हैव टेकन, 2 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2 इज 4, और हाफ एक्स वाई ये हमने सेपरेट इसलिए किया ताकि हम ये वाली जो वैल्यू है वो उसमें पुट कर सके. So here after putting the value of this 100%, what we get 400%. So double करने के बाद जो हमारा area हो गया है, that is 400%. पहले कितना था, 100% था area, double करने के बाद अब जो area हो गया है हमारा, that is 400%. और हमें क्या बताना है, what is the percentage increase in the area of the triangle. तो कितना percentage increase हुआ है, 100 से 400 हुआ, it means कितना increment हुआ है, 300% का increment हुआ है. So here option C is the correct answer. Now question number 40. In this question we have A ratio B, that is equal to 3:5. तो हमारे पास ए रेशियो बी की वैल्यू गिवन है 3:5 एंड वी हैव ए रेशियो सी दैट इज इक्वल टू 5:7. हमें बी माइनस सी रेशियो बी प्लस सी की वैल्यू निकालनी है. सबसे पहले हम लोग वैल्यू निकालते हैं. ए रेशियो बी कैन बी रिटन एज ए अपॉन बी दैट इज इक्वल टू 3/5 और यहाँ पे हम ले लेते हैं ए अपॉन सी इक्वल टू 5/7. इस तरह से हमने लिख लिया. नाउ फर्स्ट स्टेप क्या है, वी आर गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई दिस ए अपॉन बी बाय द नंबर 5. सो हियर आफ्टर द मल्टीप्लीकेशन वी गेट 15/25. सो हियर वैल्यू ऑफ ए अपॉन बी इज 15/25 एंड हियर ए अपॉन सी विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 3. हमने दोनों साइड 3 से मल्टीप्लाई किया ताकि ए की जो वैल्यू है वो क्या हमारे पास सेम आ जाए. यहाँ पर आ गया 15/21. नाउ बाय दिस स्टेप वी हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ ए दैट इज ए इज इक्वल टू 15. ए 15 हो गया है, बी हमारे पास 25 है एंड सी इज इक्वल टू 21. अब तीनों वेरिएबल्स की वैल्यू हमारे पास आ चुकी है. नाउ व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी विल जस्ट पुट द वैल्यूज एंड वी विल गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द आंसर. नाउ बी माइनस सी इज 25-21 रेशियो 25+21. सो हियर 25-21 इज 4:46. So here option A is the correct answer. Now in the 41st question, we have 3 statements. In this 3 statements, we have to find out which statement is true and which statement is false. Now let's begin with the first statement. First statement kehti hai, rational number can be expressed in fraction form, not as decimal expression. Ye kehta hai ki jo rational number hota hai, wo kya hota hai? Fraction form ke andar hi express kar sakte hain. Decimal expressions mein hum log एक्सप्रेस नहीं कर सकते. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स क्योंकि हमारे रैशनल नंबर डेसिमल एक्सप्रेशंस में भी एक्सप्रेस किए जा सकते हैं, जैसे टर्मिनेटिंग है, रिपीटिंग डेसिमल्स है, लाइक दिस. सो फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स. नेक्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज द स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ रैशनल नंबर मे बी इरैशनल. जो स्क्वायर रूट होता है रैशनल नंबर का, मे बी हो सकता है रैशनल नंबर भी हो सकता है रैशनल नंबर भी हो. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू. नेक्स्ट है द फ्रैक्शन 5/7 इज इक्विवेलेंट टू 15/21. जो फ्रैक्शन है 5/7 ये इक्विवेलेंट है 15/21 के. तो यस इट इज ट्रू, इट इज 3/7. सो द लास्ट स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू. सो यहाँ पर सीक्वेंस क्या है, फॉल्स ट्रू ट्रू. सो हियर फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स एंड रेस्ट टू आर ट्रू. सो हियर ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 42. इन दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 42 वी हैव व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट इज आर ट्रू और फॉल्स. हमें ट्रू और फॉल्स बताना है. हमारे पास 3 स्टेटमेंट है. फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट है हमारे पास, अ बार इज सुटेबल फॉर डिस्प्लेइंग कंटिन्यूअस डेटा. क्या हमें जो बार दिया जाता है वो कंटिन्यूअस डेटा को रिप्रेजेंट करता है? फॉल्स. नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन इज द मोड इज मोस्ट फ्रीक्वेंट वैल्यू इन डेटाबेस. तो जो मोड होता है वो बहुत ही फ्रीक्वेंट वैल्यू है. यस इट इज ट्रू. हमारे जो डेटा होता है उसी का फ्रीक्वेंट वैल्यू जो होता है दैट इज मोड. थर्ड स्टेटमेंट इज अ लाइन ग्राफ इज बेस्ट फॉर शोइंग ट्रेंड और चेंज ओवर टाइम. बिल्कुल, जो लाइन ग्राफ होता है वो ट्रेंड्स वगैरह पूरा अच्छे से शो करता है. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज ऑल्सो ट्रू. सो यहाँ पे जो सीक्वेंस है वो है फॉल्स ट्रू ट्रू. सो हियर ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 43. इसके अंदर भी हमें क्या करना है, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट विच स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू एंड विच स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स. नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट. फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज द रेशियो 5/8 और वी कैन से दैट 5:8 इज ग्रेटर देन द रेशियो 2:3. तो यहाँ पे हमें कंपैरिजन करना है. कंपैरिजन करने के लिए हमारे पास दोनों के डिनोमिनेटर डिफरेंट है, तो इनके डिनोमिनेटर को कर लेते हैं सेम. So now let's read the statement again. The ratio 5:8 is greater than. ये कहता है कि जो 5:8 है, it means जो 15/24 है, वो greater है 2:3 से, यानी 16/24 से. Is it true? No, it is not true. So it is false. Next statement है 20% of 18 is equal to 16. 20% means 20/100 multiply by 18. So here we get, so it is not equal to 16. So this statement is also false. Now the third statement, the cube of a number is always greater than the number itself. जो cube होता है किसी भी number का वो हमेशा greater होता है खुद के number से. तो ये statement भी false है. Why it is false? Because अगर कोई negative number होगा और उसका हम लोग cube करेंगे तो वहां पर क्या हो जाएगा, जो number हमारे पास original number है cube उससे भी छोटा हो जाएगा. So this statement is also false. So here the sequence is false, false and false. So correct answer हमारे पास है option A. Now the next question. Next question is match the column. चलो फटाफट से solve कर लेते हैं. 2/3 of a number is 20 less than the original number. Let the number be x and here 2/3 of a number is 20 less than the original number. The original number अगर हमारा x है तो ये हो गया x minus 20. Here let's solve the value. So here x is 60. P का आंसर क्या हो गया, 60. Let's solve q. 5x minus 2x and here 8 plus 7. So it will x is 5. So q ka answer aa gaya 3. And the last is a number whose double is 45. Koi number hai uska double 45 hai greater than its half, then the number is, let the number be x. And here it will be double. और ये हो गया हाफ, दैट इज इक्वल टू 45. सो हियर 4x माइनस x इक्वल टू 90 एंड x इज इक्वल टू 30. द सीक्वेंस इज 1, 3, 2. यहां पर ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. Now the next question is question number 45. और इसमें हमें क्या करना है, इसमें हमें match the column करना है with the correct cube root. So here the first is cube root of 343 is 7. ये direct question है. Cube root of 729 अगर आपको याद है तो आप easily find out कर सकते हो. Cube root of 512 is 8. So the correct sequence is 2, 1, 3. So here 2, 1, 3 is in the D option. Now the next question is question number 46. Question number 46 में हमें क्या करना है, match the column. Now here the first p part is आपके पास under root के अंदर है. हम लोग last से start करते हैं. 10 plus under root 25 plus, अब 121 का square root क्या हो जाएगा, that is 11. Next step will be 10 plus 6 and that is 16. 16 ka ho gaya 4. So here answer of P is 4. Now the next Q part. Q part ke andar aapke paas hai 3A is equal to 4B and A plus B is equal to 7 under root 29. Ye aapko given hai aur aapko value nikalni hai under root A square plus B square. Yahan par hum kya karenge? Sabse pehle A ki value nikal lenge. That is 4B upon 3. Ye value hum log put karenge A plus B वाली इक्वेशन में. So here 4B upon 3 plus B equal to 7 under root 29. LCM ले लेंगे, ये हो जाएगा 4B plus 3B equal to 21 under root 29. So here 7B is equal to 21 under root 29. That is B is equal to 21 under root 29 upon 7. Cancellation करने के बाद B आ गया हमारे पास 3 under root 29. और B square, we squaring करेंगे both the side, then we will get 9 multiply by 29. तो B की value हमारे, B square की value हमारे पास आ गई है. अब हम find out करेंगे B की value, इनमें substitute करके क्या value आती है. A is equal to 4. B की value हमारे पास है 3 under root 29 upon 3. 3 से 3 cancel हो गया. A की value आप 4 multiply by under root 29. और A square क्या हो जाएगा हमारे पास 16. मल्टीप्लाई बाय 29. हमें क्या करना है, अंडर रूट ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर में वैल्यू पुट करनी है. वी हैव नाउ 16 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 29 प्लस बी स्क्वायर है 9 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 29. तो यहाँ पर आपके पास आ गया है 29 कॉमन एंड हेयर वी हैव 16 प्लस 9 दिस विल बी 25 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 29. तो 25 हो गया 5 एंड दिस विल बी 5 अंडर रूट 29. So here the correct answer is 5 under root 29. 45 multiply by 20 का करेंगे. 45 को हम लोग लिख सकते हैं 3 × 3 × 5 and for 20 we can write like this 2 × 2 × 5. यहाँ पर pairing हो जाएगी. So after pairing what we will get, 3 × 2 × 5 and that is 6 × 5 and you will get 30. So R is 30. So correct sequence kya ho gayi? 3 1 2. So 3 1 2 is the correct sequence. So option A is the correct answer. Now, the next question is based on the paragraph. हमारे पास एक pie chart given है और इस information को हमें use में लेकर question solve करना है. Question है, हमें approximately find out करना है how many degree should be there in the central angle. Central angle में कितनी degree होगी? Of the sector for agriculture expenditure. This is the agriculture expenditure. Now here, total degree होती है हमारे पास 360 upon 100. We will get 3.6 और 3.6 को हम मल्टीप्लाई कर देते हैं 59 से. सो हियर वी विल गेट 212.4 अप्रोक्सीमेटली. सो हियर ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज ऑल्सो बेस्ड ऑन द सेम पैराग्राफ. हियर द क्वेश्चन इज इफ रुपीज 90 मिलियन वर स्पेंड इन 2022-23 ऑन डेयरी वॉट वुड हैव बीन द टोटल एक्सपेंस in that year in millions. कितना expense होगा total? तो हमारे पास dairy पे है 6% और total कितना rupees है? 90 million. So let it be 90 million upon 6 multiply by 100. So here after cancellation we will get 1500. So here option A is the correct answer. Now the next question is a farmer having a square field of area 2,304 meter square want to grow some crop in the field. He decided to fence the field. Help him by solving the following question. हमें क्या करना है? Question के अंदर हमें area already given है paragraph के अंदर. अब question क्या कहता है? क्या find out करना है? If area of square is increased by 3172. 3172 से अगर इंक्रीज हो गया तो पहले हमारा एरिया क्या था 2304 और अब इंक्रीज हो गया हमारा 3172 से. अब क्या कहते हैं? देन पैरामीटर ऑफ स्क्वायर विल बी. हमें पैरामीटर फाइंड आउट करना है. तो पैरामीटर फाइंड आउट करने के लिए सबसे पहले हमें चाहिए साइड. तो ये हो गया हमारा एरिया, इट मींस साइड स्क्वायर. सो लेट्स कैलकुलेट. साइड हमारे पास आ गई है, डेट इज 74 और पैरामीटर फाइंड आउट करना है. तो पैरामीटर का फॉर्मूला होता है 4 × साइड, इट मींस 4 × 74 इज 296. सो हियर ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर, डेट इज 296 मीटर. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज द एरिया ऑफ स्क्वायर विद साइड 1.12 मीटर विल बी. हमें स्क्वायर का एरिया फाइंड आउट करना है जिसमें साइड है 1.12. सो स्क्वायर ऑफ 1.12 इज 1.2544 मीटर स्क्वायर. सो हियर ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. सो आई होप यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड ऑल द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ दिस पार्ट. थैंक यू.
हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू मैट्रिक्स यूट्यूब चैनल। वी आर हेयर टू डिस्कस द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ मैट्रिक्स ओलंपियाड पेपर ऑफ क्लास 8 रीजनिंग कंडक्टेड ऑन 8 अक्टूबर 2023। होप यू परफॉर्म्ड वेरी वेल। ओके, लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 51, फाइंड द नेक्स्ट टर्म। फाइंड द नेक्स्ट टर्म, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फाइंड द पैटर्न ऑफ द क्वेश्चन। सो पैटर्न ऑफ द क्वेश्चन इज 6, 15, 35, 77, and 143। फाइंड द नेक्स्ट नंबर। सो पैटर्न ऑफ द सीरीज इज 2 × 3, इट मीन्स 6। ओके, 3 × 5, इट मीन्स 15। ओके, 5 × 7, इट मीन्स 35। नाउ 7 मल्टीप्लाई बाई नेक्स्ट प्राइम नंबर, 2 मल्टीप्लाई नेक्स्ट प्राइम नंबर, इट मीन्स 3, 2 × 3, इट मीन्स 6। 3 मल्टीप्लाई नेक्स्ट प्राइम नंबर, 3 × 5, इट मीन्स 15। 5 × मल्टीप्लाई नेक्स्ट प्राइम नंबर, इट मीन्स 7। 5 × 7, 35। 7 मल्टीप्लाई नेक्स्ट प्राइम नंबर, इट मीन्स 11। इट मीन्स 7 × 11, इट मीन्स 77। ओके, 11 × नेक्स्ट प्राइम नंबर, इट्स 13। 11 × 13, इट मीन्स 143। नाउ 13 मल्टीप्लाई नेक्स्ट प्राइम नंबर, सो नेक्स्ट प्राइम नंबर इज 17। सो नेक्स्ट प्राइम नंबर इज 17, तो 13 × 17, इट मीन्स 221। मीन्स ऑप्शन डी इज द नेक्स्ट टर्म ऑफ दिस सीरीज। ओके, नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच सिक्वेंस ऑफ लेटर व्हेन प्लेस्ड एट द ब्लैंक्स वन आफ्टर द अदर विल कंप्लीट द गिवन लेटर सीरीज। सो सीरीज इज ब्लैंक एक्स ब्लैंक वाई ब्लैंक एक्स वाई एक्स एक्स ब्लैंक वाई एक्स वाई ब्लैंक एक्स वाई वाई एंड एक्स। सो इन दिस टाइप क्वेश्चन पुट द ऑप्शन 1 × 1 एंड सी विच वन विल फॉलो करेक्टली। ओके, सो टेकिंग ऑप्शन डी, ऑप्शन डी, इट मीन्स वाई एक्स वाई वाई एंड एक्स। ओके, चेक द सीरीज, वाई एक्स एक्स वाई एक्स एक्स वाई वाई एक्स वाई वाई एक्स वाई एक्स एक्स वाई एक्स एक्स वाई वाई एक्स वाई वाई एक्स वाई एक्स एक्स वाई एक्स एक्स एंड वाई वाई एक्स वाई वाई एक्स। सो ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर। सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 53, वुड कम इन प्लेस ऑफ क्वेश्चन मार्क इन द फॉलोइंग लेटर सीरीज। सो फर्स्ट राइट द फर्स्ट अल्फाबेट ऑफ ईच टर्म। सो फर्स्ट अल्फाबेट ऑफ ईच टर्म इज W T Q एंड क्वेश्चन मार्क नेक्स्ट मिसिंग टर्म। ओके, W मीन्स 23, ओके, T मीन्स 20, Q मीन्स 17, सो -3 एंड -3, सो 17 माइनस 3 इट मीन्स 14, 14 मीन्स N, सो फर्स्ट मिसिंग अल्फाबेट इज N। ओके, Now write all second letter F, G, H and question mark. Okay, F means 6, G means 7, H means 8. 6, 7, 8, now next is 9. So 9 means I. So second alphabet of missing term is I. Okay, N, I. Okay, now write third alphabet of each term. Okay, so third alphabet is B, D, G and missing term. Okay, B means 2, D means 4, G means 7, plus 2, plus 3, now plus 4. Plus 4 means 11, 7 plus 4 it means 11, 11 means K. N, I, K is the correct next term. Okay, so option B is the correct answer. Now let's move on to the next question. Next question is Y is in the east of X, which is in the north of Z. I P is the south of Z, then in which direction of P with respect to Y? Before starting this question, we should know that there are four type of main direction. One is east, west, north and south. And there are four cardinal direction. One is northeast, southeast, southwest and northwest. Okay, Y is in the east of X. Y is in east of X. Y is in east of X. Okay, now next is which is north of Z. It means X is north of Z. X is in north of Z. If P is in the south of Z, if P is in the south of Z, P is in the south of Z, then in which direction of P with respect to Y? So in which direction of P with respect to Y? So this is the south of Y and this is the west of Y. Okay, so P is in the southwest of Y. So southwest. So southwest is means none of these. Southwest is not there. So right answer is none of these. Next question is question number 55. Question number 55, choose the alternatives which is closely resembles the voter image of the given combination. So find the voter image of nuclear. Find the voter image of NUCLEAR. So voter image of N, voter image of N is formed as follows. Voter image of U looks like this. Voter image of C, voter image of L, voter image of E, voter image of A and voter image of R. So voter image of nuclear, it means option A. Here option A is the correct voter image of nuclear. To the next question. So next question is, in a row of 56 people, A is 17 place from left and B is 25 place from right side. Find the number of people between A and B. Okay. Total people is 56. Okay. Position of A from left side is 17. Okay. Position of B from right side is 25. Okay. Find the number of people between A and B. If total is greater than 2 left plus right position, then number of mid people is equal to total minus left plus right. Okay. So total is 56 minus left position. Left position is 17 plus right position, it means 25. Okay, 56 minus 17 plus 25, it means 42. So 56 minus 42, it means 14. So there are 14 people between A and B. So correct answer is option B. Okay. Let's move on to the next question. So next question is question number 56. In a row of student, Asis is 15th place from the right end and Neha is 10th place from the left end. If in this row, Neha is 20 place from the right end, then what is the position of Asis from left end? Okay. In a row, Asis is 15th place from right side. Asis is 15th place from right side. Okay. Neha is 10th place. So Neha is 10th place from left side. 10th place from left side. Okay. If in this row. Neha is 12 plays from right side. So position of Neha from the right side is 12. Okay. Then what is the position of Asis from left end? Okay. First, find the total. Total student. So total is equal to left plus right of same person. Left position plus right position of same person minus 1. So here left position and right position of same person. Neha. Neha is 10 place from left and 12 place from right. Okay. Minus 1. So 22 minus 1. It means total student in this row is 21. Okay. Now find the position of Asis from the left end. Position of Asis from the left end is equals to. So formula of left end, it means total minus right side plus 1. So total is 21 minus position of Asis from the right side. Position of Asis from the right side, it means 15 plus 1. 15 plus 1, it means 22 minus 15. Asis is 7th place from left side in this. So correct answer is option B. Okay, let's move on to the next question. So next question is question number 58. If greater than denotes plus less than denotes minus plus denote divide minus denote equals denote less than and multiply denotes greater than. Find which of the following is a correct statement. Okay. So, taking option A is 3 plus 2 greater than 4 is equals to 9 plus 3 less than 2. Okay. Substitute the sign. 3 plus means divide. 3 divided by 2 greater than. So, greater than means plus. 4 equals to means less than. 9 plus means divide. 3 less than means minus 2. Okay. 3 divided by 2, it means 1.5 plus 4 less than. 9 divided by 3, it means 3 minus 2. Okay. 1.5 plus 4, it means 5.5 is greater than 1. So 5.5 is not greater than 1. So option A is the incorrect option. Now taking option B. So option B is 3 greater than 2 greater than 4 is equals to 18 plus 3 less than 1. Okay. 3 greater than means plus 2. Greater than means plus 4 equals to means less than. 18 plus means divide. 3 or less than means minus 1. Okay. So now 3 plus 2, 5 plus 4, it means 9 less than. Okay. 9 less than 18 divided by 3, it means 6 minus 1. 9 less than 5. So 9 never less than 5. So option B also incorrect option. Now we're taking option C. Option C is 3 greater than 2 less than 4 multiply 8 plus 4 less than 2. Okay. Substitute the symbols 3. Okay. Greater than means plus 2. Less than means minus 4. Multiply denotes greater than 8 plus means divide 4 less than denotes minus 2. Okay. 3 plus 2, it means 5 minus 4 is greater than 8 divided by 4, it means 2 minus 2. Okay. 5 minus 4, it means 1 is greater than 2 minus 2, it means 0. Yes, 1 is always greater than 2, 0. So option C is the correct answer. Now Let's move on to the next question. So next question is, if plus means multiply, multiply means minus, divide means plus, and minus means divide, then what is the value of, what is the, find the value of given expression. So 625 minus 25 divided by 5 plus 20 into 3 plus 10. Okay. 20 into 10. Okay. So now substitute the sign. 625 minus. So minus means divide. 25. Okay. Divide. Divide means plus 5. Okay. Plus means multiply. 20. Okay. Multiply means minus 3. Okay. Plus means multiply 10. Okay. Using board mass, 625 divided by 25, it means 25 plus 5 into 20, it means 100 minus 3 into 10, it means 30. Okay. 25 plus 100, it means 125 minus 30. So 125 minus 30, it means 95. So 95 is the correct value of this equation. So right answer is option B. Okay. Now question number 60. A sheet has been folded in the manners as shown in X, Y, and Z respectively and punched. You have to choose from the alternatives how it will look when unfold. So find the unfold paper. So we find image of X because X represents unfold paper. In this type question, unfold the paper in the same sequence in which it was folded and find the mirror image in each case. When we unfold Z, it's represent Y. When we unfold Y, it's represent X, and find the image of X because X represents unfold paper. So first of all, find the mirror image of Z. So mirror image of Z. So mirror image of Z looks like this. And then it's represent Y. And then find the mirror image of Y. So mirror image of Y It's represent X. X is the unfold paper. So here option B is the unfold paper. So correct answer is option B. Thank you everyone.